Hi guys, quick video on the next stage of Deadbugs and core activation. Okay, so Deadbugs is a really excellent exercise that we've been using to help engage the lower abs, but so far we've kind of done a sort of more generic version of it that's just really isolated, just gets the abs working. And what we've been doing obviously is asking you to take the bands and to really encourage extra engagement of the abs. We've asked you to push forward through the shoulders and bring the head up to create that sort of abdominal crunch position, which automatically really helps put you in touch with your abs, which is really useful to get you aware of what it feels like to engage those muscles. However, this is just one step to the next progression. This is because if you think about it, when you want to engage your abs naturally when you're walking about, you can't walk about really round your shoulders in order to do it, because obviously you walk about kind of weird. The idea is to get you used to the sensation of engaging the abs, but then you become really good at keeping the shoulders back and a nice flat back and head up when you're walking about like this. So the next thing we've also been asked to do with Deadbugs is to make sure that you press your lower back down into the floor to engage the abs. And again, we've been saying that if you reach up, it will help push the lower back down. But the next stage of this is to make sure that you do that without the assistance of this, which means you need to get more in touch with what's going on in your pelvis, essentially, to the point where you want to actually control the pelvis without having to worry about what's going on up here. So one of the first things we need to do to get used to this is get the breathing right. So what we want to first of all do is think about taking a big inhale breath, okay, like as in through the nose. And as you do that, it's kind of hard to talk at the same time, but as you do that, you should feel everything sort of like, your belly kind of fill up with air a wee bit, that everything kind of expands through the ribs and stuff. And what we're really looking for, there's still a wee gap here at the lower back, because I'm not really focused on engaging yet. On the exhale, you want to exhale, and as you exhale, ideally, your pelvis will tuck under, or maybe what we're always going to tuck under the tailbone, the pelvis will kind of naturally tuck under and move, because the exhale should help encourage the lower abs to kick in. Okay, so what we're looking for is a movement through the hips, almost involuntary, but it's because the lower abs are doing their job. So obviously if you've been a baby, this is probably going to be harder than if you're not a baby, but this is one you can practice in the house, and it all starts probably with the breath. So and you can initially start by taking a few big inhales, like, and then pushing it and then exhaling it through your mouth. Even just doing that, the deep breathing through the belly and then exhale, you might actually think, oh, I can feel my stomach muscles sort of tensing up a wee bit there. That's the whole point, right? So it's to engage the lower ab muscles and all the muscles, all the deeper core muscles, okay? So what we're looking for, I'm going to try and demonstrate it, is hopefully you see a bit of movement through the pelvis here when I breathe, and it's the breathing that connects the core to the pelvis. So what we're doing here is I'm going to move my hand, as you can see this area with my hand moving there. So at the moment there's not a huge amount of engagement here. There's a wee bit because I've got a reasonable core, but it's not massive, the engagement. So I'm going to take a deep breath in to try and fill up the stomach, okay? And on the again, it's hard to talk and do this again. As I exhale, hopefully the lower back will press down into the floor, the pelvis will move, and my knees will probably come this way because I'm sort of focusing on it. So like that, okay, so there's one rep. And suddenly my lower back's firing right down into the ground, and I've exhaled, and the pelvis has moved, it's been moved because I've engaged the core. When you can sort of relax it again with a big deep inhale. And same happens again. The pelvis and the knees come forward, like almost involuntary, because you're using the breath to help tap into the lower abs, okay? So that is the next stage. And the reason that becomes important is because one, it's much more effective for longer term because your back's now flat, and you're not having to do this to get this, you don't need to commit this ridiculous posture to engage your abs, okay? And it equally becomes important, so again, you can't drop down at the same time, but you take a deep breath in and then you start to slowly straighten one leg. You can always do it at the tempo of your breath. So as I'm doing this, I'm breathing out harder, and I'm really concentrating on keeping the pelvis tucked in order to put the lower back down, which is really hard to do when you're talking at the same time. You might even see that this, I don't know if you can see it, but this is shaking a wee bit, everything's shaking because it's so hard. Okay, and as you slowly bring the leg up, it gets easier because there's less of a lever putting less pressure on your core to hold the pelvis down. Take a big deep breath in and go the other way. And again, you can't do it because I'm talking, but you can kind of do it subconsciously if you know what you're doing. And focus on really pushing or keeping the pelvis down. As the leg goes out, it's harder and harder to do that, especially if I'm not focusing on breathing because I'm talking. Okay, so that's the next stage I want you to think about. So think about the deep breath in through the nose to expand the stomach and everything else. And then as you exhale, you should feel like that the pelvis automatically comes down. Okay, so that's the next stage of the dead bug. And the reason that becomes relevant is obviously when you stand up, you can't engage your core by doing this, right? Because obviously that's not ideal at all. And that's another reason for weak core muscles, is this posture. Because the core is not just about the abs, it's about the deep core muscles, also the glutes and the hamstrings. And the glutes switch off when you walk about like this, right? So you need to be able to keep it all in alignment as you're performing movements. So you can even practice standing up, like you take a big deep belly breath. And just exhaling. And as you exhale, you'll feel the core. But you also want to try and be aware that you're not doing this, and that's where the dead bug comes in handy, because you can keep your head and shoulders back on the floor as you do it. Okay, so hopefully that makes sense. I think that's worth practicing in the house, so you can start to get more out of the dead bugs. And as you start to progress them by extending the leg out, you start to be more in touch with what you're meant to be doing in terms of the breathing, and really getting that pelvis to stay pushed down into the floor without relying on a forward posture and without relying on the weights. So the weights and the bands are really good to encourage you as a start point, but long term you want to be able to get away from that and get it flat. The problem is, if you start it too early, if you start from day one just lying dead flat, you might struggle to tap into the sensation of the engagement of the abs. So it depends. Some people might argue you're better off starting from the start and just focusing on the breathing, but something like it's better just to get the abs strengthened a wee bit first, and you can practice it and build up on it. Okay, so that's a wee exercise to focus on for your breathing and deadbugs.